Hi guys and welcome to Softskins. In this video we will see how to build a pyramid from Asterix and how to do it in two different ways by using two different approaches and also how you can deal with similar problems. Before to start with all this, I wanted to say thank you for the likes and also for the good words. I really appreciate them. And also to say that if you have any ideas, problems or questions, you can share them and I will try to answer to them. So let's start with how you can deal with similar problems. You need to try to find a pattern or formula for this problem. And then you can try to implement this formula in your solution. And can you find a pattern or formula for this shape here? Or in other words, can you say how many asterisks do we have for a given row? And can you find a formula for this one? So for row 0 we have 1. And you can notice that in programming we start counting from 0. For row 1 we have 3. For row 2 we have 5. Can you say what is the formula and which is giving the result for this given input to have the output? If you are able to say it, congratulations, you're really a good programmer and you have good way of thinking and good basics for programming. The formula is 2 multiplied on the number of the row plus 1. And with this formula we can build similar shape here, or at least the number of the asterisks per each row. And let's start implementing this solution for the given example n equal to 3. First we'll have a range from n. As you can notice, we can define a range using two arguments or using a single argument. And in this case we are going to have range from 0 to n. Then we need to apply our formula and we can say this is our row. And for our row we want to print asterisk multiplied on our formula. And we can take our formula which is defined already above and we can use it. Finally, you can add some good comment in order to make your code more readable and more explicit. For example, calculating the asterisk for a given row based on formula or something else. All depends on your needs and your understanding of a given piece of code. And let's try to print out a given row and check what is going to be the output. We have a triangle, not a pyramid, but the number of the asterisks is similar as the shape above and we need to change something in order to get the same output as above. Can you say what we need to do as a change? And what is wrong here and what is missing? The first thing which is missing is that we have a space between each asterisk and also this shape here is centered. So we need to first add a space and now what we need to do is do center or some format in order to get the same shape. Let's try to use a built-in method, which is center. And let's see what is going to happen if we use it without any argument. You can see that we have an error and the error is saying that this method is taking at least one argument, but we are giving 0. If you want to change what is the signature and the body for this method, you can use shift and tab and check the information for the given method and you can see some of the arguments here and you have some positional arguments and also some default values. as you can see here, and we need at least to provide one, which is value. And what do you think that we should use here? Can you guess something? If you think that the answer is n, you're wrong. Or maybe you think that we need to use 2 multiplied on n. Again, you're going to be wrong. The correct answer is to be 3 multiplied on n, and we're going to get the desired output. And this is the end of the first solution. And let's start with different solution on the same problem. And this time we're not going to build the first, the shape and the number of the asterisks for a given row, but we're going to build a shape which is on the left from this pyramid, and only then build the other shape. So how can you build a triangle which is on the left of this pyramid? Can you guess it? Yes, we are going to start with for e in range n. Then we are going to try to find a formula which is going to give us this triangle on the left. Let's put x, and can you guess what is going to be the formula here? I can give you, and the formula is n minus I minus 1. And let's check what is going to happen. We have almost this triangle here. Why I'm saying almost? I don't know, maybe because we need a bigger n in order to try to imagine this triangle. And as you can see, right now we have the triangle which is on the left from this pyramid. Can you try to find out why this is working on in this way? And you can share it in the comment section below. What are your thoughts on this? And now we need to do the rest of the problem to build our pyramid. And for building the pyramid, we can reuse the solution from the above. We can print the asterisk multiplied on our formula. And let's check what is going to happen. You see that we have the triangle, but we also have a new line between the two shapes. So we need to add end equal to empty string, which is going to remove the new line after the first print of the first shape. And as you can see right now, we have a better looking shape if we remove the first. In this way, we are not printing anything for the first row or the first shape. We'll have a triangle similar to the previous solution. And if we add empty space, we'll have almost a pyramid. So we need to add only the spaces. And this I will give you for a homework. Can you make from this pyramid and this solution the solution above? And if you have any ideas or problems for solving, please do share them. I will try to cover them in a future video. Thank you for watching and hope to see you next time.